We often hear that it takes very long to incorporate measurement instruments into measurement programs. So in this video, I will show you how to get started with our instruments and our APIs within only a few minutes, focusing on the LabView API this time. Let's start with a basic example, but typical use case. We make settings in the user interface and read the data from the login amplifier using the LabView API. So let's get started. First, we connect the login to the computer and loop the signal output to the voltage input. Then we launch the LabOne user interface and choose our login amplifier. The UI opens and we define a test signal with a frequency of 500 kHz and 10 mV amplitude. We send this to the output. The loopback signal is then measured using the first demodulator. Displaying its result, we read the expected 7.07 mV RMS signal. Now we open LabView. Earlier I downloaded the Zurich Instruments LabView driver and copied it into instru.lib. As a result, you find it in the Instruments drivers folder in the function palette. Let's start programming. We have to open a connection first. We add the serial number of the login amplifier we want to connect. And we need to close the connection at the end of the program. Now, in between, we can interact with the instrument. The data readout needs to be, of course, put into the right place of your program. For example, after your magnetic field or delay stage reached the right state. In this example, we will read a sample every 100 milliseconds. To read out one demodulator value, we use the getValue command. We connect this to the open and the close VI. We define the path for the first demodulator, which you can find in the user's manual. And then, since it's a polymorphic command, we configure its selector to demod. The sample depends on the selected source. For the demodulator, for instance, it is a bundle that contains the two quadratures, X and Y, the frequency, the oscillator phase, the auxiliary signal, the trigger signal, and a timestamp. After unbundling them, you have access to all the elements. In this example, the two quadratures are displayed and can also be easily converted into polar representation of the amplitude R and phase theta. So, let's run the VI. And here we go. This is the first readout result achieved with the LabView API. And still, as you can see, the user interface can provide the results simultaneously. Naturally, this example is only the starting point. It shows a basic way of interacting with our instruments. The driver, though, provides much more functionality and allows fast implementation of rather complex measurements, such as streaming with high data rate or perform frequency sweeps. The LabOne VI tree summarizes it, following the same structure we have seen in the example. Initialize, configure, get the data, and close the connection. You can also find additional information on the LabView API in the LabOne programming manual, including some best practices. In future videos, we will explore some of the more advanced functions and also how to use our other APIs like MATLAB, Python, and C. As we have seen, it's rather easy to get started programming our instruments with LabView. And the programming and user manual provides accessible references whenever you feel stuck. So there you have it. It took less than 5 minutes to get the data from our login amplifier with the LabView API. Try it yourself and let us know about your project. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.